Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Jambulkar. In last video, we have seen matrix multiplication, and in that video, we have seen simple algorithm for matrices multiplication. In this video, we will see Kanon's algorithm for matrix multiplication, and it is a parallel algorithm or it is a parallel implementation of matrix multiplication. Here, what matrices that we are considering are the square matrices. Normally, how we multiply matrices? Suppose these are the two matrices and this is the resultant matrix. So, how we multiply matrices? So, A1 into B1 plus A2 into B3, it gives C1. Then for C2, A1 into B2 plus A2 into B4, it gives C2. In the same way, we calculate remaining values like this. So here we are considering only one process, and one process is computing everything. So this is the serial algorithm. Now there are many parallel algorithms are available. Out of that, Kanon's algorithm is one of the parallel algorithm which computes matrix multiplication parallelly. So we will take one example, so from that it will be very clear. So suppose we have two matrices, matrix A and matrix B. So these are the elements of matrix A and these are the elements of matrix B. Now in this case, we are assuming every element of this matrix is processed by one process. For example, P0 for this element, P1 for this element, P2 for this element. So P0 process will process this element and this element. P1 process will process this element and this element. So total number of process that we require here, 4 rows and 4 columns. So that's why total number of process that we require is 16. Now see. So in this case, total number of processes in this example will be 16, as there are 4 rows and 4 columns. Now see, in this case, total number of steps that we require is square root of P. So P is 16. So square root of 16, that is 4. So total we require 4 steps. So here you can see, this is a step 1. In step 1, we have to calculate A1, B1, and from that we'll calculate C1. Then, so we have to follow some procedure for that. In step 2, again, we'll find out A2, B2, and from that A2 and B2 we'll find out C2. Then step 3, so here we'll find out A3, B3, and from A3 and B3, we'll find out C3. In the same way, we'll find out step 4, here we'll find out A4 and B4 from A3 and B3, and from A4 and B4, we'll find out C4, and finally, we will compute C, that is addition of all these 4 matrices. So C1 we will get from step 1, C2 we will get from step 2, C3 we will get from step 3, and C4 we will get from step 4. We will add them, and this is the resultant matrix, that is a product of matrices A and B that you will get at the end. Now we will see what procedure we have to follow in each step. Step 1 is somewhat different from step 2, 3 and 4. So how it is different, afterwards we'll see. Now look at this. So in step 1, we'll find A1 from A. So this is our A matrix. Here we have to perform some shift operation. So on first row will apply 0 left shift operation, then on second row 1 left shift, then on third row 2 left shift, fourth row 3 left shift. So 0 left shift means nothing, this row will be as it is. Then 1 left shift, so 9, so nothing is there, so it will come like this, it is a circular shift. Here you can see, then 8 will come to this side, 7 will come to this side, 6 will come to this side. Then 2 left shift, so 5, 2 left shift means in the sense 1 2, so here you can see 2 left shift, so 1 2, 4 will come here. Then 2 left shift means 1 2, so 2 will come here, and again for 3, 2 left shift means 1 2, so it will be like this. And for third row we will have 3 left shift, so by this way we will get A1. Now see how to find out B1. So we will find out B1 from B. So this is our matrix B. Here we have to apply up shift. So for A we have applied 0, here we have applied left shift, 0 left shift, up, 1 left shift, 2 left shift, 3 left shift. In the same way here we have to apply up shift. So 0 up shift for first column, 1 up shift for second, 2 up shift for third, 3 up shift for fourth column. So again in the same way, 0 up shift means this will be as it is, 1 up shift, so it will be circular up shift, means 5 will come to this side, 7 will come here, 5 will come here, 3 will come here. Again 2 up shift means 7 will come here, 1 2, 6 will come here, 1 2 means last, 3 will come here, as it is a 2 up shift, 1 2, and 2 will come 1 2 here. In the same way here it will be 3 up shift. So here you can see this is our resultant matrix. So we got B1. So we find out A1 and B1 from A and B. Now we will find out C1, and C1 is calculated from A1 and B1. So how it is calculated? Now see, to find out C1, so each element of C1 is calculated as multiplication of individual element of A1 and B1. In the sense, now look at this. So this is A1. So 2, look at this, 2 into 3. So that becomes 6. So each element we are multiplying. Individually we are multiplying. For example, see, this is a 21. So how we got 21? So that respective element will multiply. For example, A1 is 3, so 3 into 7, 3 into 7, so that is a 21. So every element from A and respective element from B will multiply, so we will get respective element of C1. So in this way, from A1 and B1 we will find out C1. So here we got matrix C1. Okay, so now we'll have step 2. So step 2, step 3, step 4 are similar, while step 1 was somewhat different. Now see, what is the difference? In step 1, there we have applied 0 left shift, 1 left shift, 2 left shift, 3 left shift. Here, from step 2 onwards, we'll apply only 1 left shift. So for every row we'll apply 1 left shift. Here you can see 1 left shift, 1 left shift, 1 left shift, 1 left shift. And again for finding B2 matrix from B1, here we'll apply 1 up shift. So in step 1 we have applied 0 up shift, 2, 1 up shift, 2 up shift, 3 up shift. But from step 2 onwards, here we will apply only 1 shift. Now see, in the same way So in step 2, we are finding A2 from A1. And how we are finding? We are applying one left shift operation on each row. So by following that, we'll get matrix A2. Then we'll find out B2 from B1. And how we'll find out? By applying upshift. So on every column we'll apply upshift. This is circular upshift. So for every column, on every column we'll apply one upshift. So by this way we'll get B2. And again, for we'll find out C2 from A2 and B2. So each element of A2 and B2 will multiply, so that we will get respective element of C2. So what procedure we have done in step 1, same procedure will apply here. We will multiply individual element of these two matrices A2 and B2. So we will get that respective element of C2. So we got this matrix C2. So whatever the procedure we have applied in step 2, same procedure we have to apply in step 3 and step 4 also. So here you can see. In step 3, we'll find out first A3 from A2 and B3 from B2. And how we'll find out? Again, we'll apply one left shift on each row on A2, so we'll get A3. And on B2, we'll apply one up shift like this. So we'll get B3. Here we got B3, and we'll find out C3 from A3 and B3. And how we'll find out? We'll multiply individual element of A3 and B3, so we'll get respective C3 element. So here we got this matrix. Individual element we will multiply. Again, in the same way, same procedure will follow in step 4. So in step 4, first we will find out A4 from A3, and for that we will apply this procedure, that is the one left shift on each row. We will apply this, so we will get this A4 from the A3 matrix. Then in step 4 we will find out B4 from B3 matrix. So B3 matrix we got in step 3. So this is a B3 matrix that we got in step 3. So here again we'll apply one shift operation, and here we got B4 matrix. In the same way, we'll multiply individual element from A4 and B4, so we'll get C4. This is how we got C4. And at the end, we will add C1 matrix, C2 matrix, C3 matrix and C4 matrix. So normal matrices addition will do, and that will give our resultant matrix. So this matrix we got, and this is the multiplication of two matrices A and B. Here we have multiplied A and B matrices, but here we have applied Kanon's algorithm. Kanon's algorithm is a parallel implementation of matrix-matrix multiplication. Here instead of one process, we have applied multiple processes. So there is one process for each element. So for example, one process is processing or working on this element and this element. Second process will work on this element and this element. Third process will work on this element and this element. So here total number of rows are 4 and total number of columns are 4. So total 16 processes will be there. And that's why we require here total number of processes were 16. So total number of steps that we require is square root of p. So p is 16. That's why we require 4 steps. Step 1 is somewhat different compared to step 2, step 3 and step 4. What is the difference? In step 1, we have to apply 0 left shift, 1 left shift, 2 left shift, 3 left shift. For finding A1 from A, and to find B1 from B, we have to apply 0 upshift, 1 upshift, 2 upshift, 3 upshift, so that we get B1. and then individual element we multiply, so we get C1. But from step 2 onwards, so there is slight difference. From step 2 onwards, what is the difference? So in step 1 we have applied 0 left shift, 1 left shift, 2 left shift, 3 left shift. Here we have to apply 1 left shift only, so that we get A2 from A1. And here we have to apply 1 up shift on each column, so that we get B2. In step 1 we apply 0 up shift, 1 up shift, 2 up shift, 3 up shift. But from step 2 onwards, we'll do only 1 up shift. So same step 3 and step 4 will follow. So from each step we'll get this matrix. C1 we got from step 1, C2 we got from step 2, C3 we got from step 3, C4 we got from step 4. We will add them and finally we get our resultant matrix C. That is the addition of all four matrices. And what is the result that we get? It is the multiplication of two matrices A and B. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.